fly away, oh glory, fly away, fly away. When Christ comes, hallelujah, by and by, fly away, fly away.
And go set it on the mountains,
over the hills,
and go tell it on the mountain
that Jesus Christ is born.
I have a joy, 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 joy down in my heart.
Down in my heart, down in my heart.
I have a joy, 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 joy down in my heart.
Down in my heart today. I am so happy, so very happy. I have the love of Jesus in my heart. I am so happy, so very happy. I have the love of Jesus in my heart. There is power, power, wonder working power in the blood of the Lamb. There is power, power, wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. When the road is called up yonder, when the road is called up yonder, when the road is called up yonder.
Come on, put your hands. Come on, put your hands together. I need some church folks to get on your feet. Come on, come on.
Oh, my, my.
I'd like to take this moment out to thank God for the many blessings He's given me. Come on, y'all. When I look back over my life and I see where He brought me from, I can truly say that I've been blessed. Let me say this. Woke up this morning, got out of my bed. I looked around and here's what I said. Thank you, Lord, for the blood you shed. You put a roof up over my head. Thank you, Lord, for another day and all these blessings you sent my way. You see, I could have been dead in some lonesome grave, but you told, oh, death, surely to get back and behave. Ooh-wee. Help me, church. Another blessing. Ooh-wee. Another blessing. Ooh-wee. Another blessing. Whoa-whoa. Another blessing. One more thing. I've never seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging for bread. I can count on God, He won't let me down. Always do just what He said. Pain and suffering He brought me through. Arms wide open, always welcome you. You see, I've been blessed so many ways. I just want to lift my hand and give God all the praise. Ooh-wee. I wish I had some help up in here. Ooh-wee. Another blessing. Ooh-wee. Look at my blessing. Ooh-wee. Another blessing. Watch this, y'all. I got my leg and I can walk. I got my tongue, y'all, and I can gentle. Even the air that I receive, got my lungs and I can breathe. And when I look around, I can see all the blessings He's given to me. Bless my family and they're doing fine. Give me peace of mind. Thank God. Anybody up in you been blessed, you ought to get on your feet. Come on, put your hands together. Thank God. Get your hands in the air. Come on. Thank God. One more day. Thank God. You made a way. Thank you, Lord. You've been good. Can always do what I should. Hey. I wish I had some help up in you. Ooh, yeah. I've been blessed. Better than blessed. And I thank you, Lord. Another blessing.
Another blessing.
Come on, give God some praise up in you. Yeah. Come on, put your hands.
Praise God for my family, my children, my friends, and my enemies. Good morning and welcome on this special Thanksgiving morning.
Yeah.
Most gracious Father, we humbly gather together to praise you for this day and for your purpose in it, O Lord. Father, we just ask that you would reset our agendas as we set in your presence, O Father. For you assured us that where two or more gather in your name, O Lord, you are in the midst, O Father. Father God, we ask that you recalibrate our intentions and refocus our hearts, O Father. Your will for our lives does not always reflect our plans. Change them to reflect your will, O Lord. Help us to understand that we don't need full clarity to walk into the unique purpose you have for us. Father, we lift our eyes to seek you first today, O Lord, and always, Father, surrendering our need to achieve, understand, and be known. Shift our perspective to seek your peace above all else, O Lord. In every situation we ponder in our heart and in our daily lives, let the Holy Spirit translate your commands for us, O Lord, and give us renewed strength and godly courage today without questioning you, O Father. Forgive us for striving beyond our means, worrying and focusing on other things. And Father God, only you know what lies ahead for us, O Father. You are our gracious Lord, just and righteous Father. Though our circumstances will be unfair from time to time in this life, O Lord, you are always an unwavering God, O Father. And we thank you for that, O Father. And Father, we just thank you for just the will of God, Father, and seeking you on a daily basis, O Father. Thank you for everyone that is on this line today, O Father. Bless them immensely, O Father. Continue to cover them with your shield of protection, O Father. Keep us through this holiday season, Thanksgiving season, O Lord. And Father God, it is in your precious Son Jesus' holy name we do pray. Amen, amen, amen.
Good morning and happy Thanksgiving to everyone. I don't have to tell you that the 2020 pandemic has put us all in a challenging position. Some of us are facing difficult challenges and maybe hanging on by a dim light and struggle to keep pressing on. But our hope is that we can continue to contribute in a way that each of you hope to endure. So enjoy this hour and be blessed. Good morning.
My name is Nishoni, and today I'm going to share with you some information about my testimony from a mystery illness that I experienced. Back in 2014, I got sick with what I still call today a mystery illness. And I was starting to experience symptoms such as not being able to breathe properly, shortness of breath. I was losing my ability to speak. I lost my voice completely. I was coughing. I had respiratory issues. I couldn't, there was just so much that was going on. And over the period of this illness, the symptoms varied, they morphed, and nobody was able to figure it out what was happening with me. Initially, one of my doctors thought that I had bronchitis, and that was quickly ruled out shortly after all the additional symptoms started to manifest themselves. I was told that I had hypersensitive airway disease, which later was found not to be the case. And in fact, you know, I saw so many doctors, so many specialists, that it was starting to get to the point of, like, if I hadn't seen a specialist, they didn't really exist. But when they could not figure out what was wrong with me, some of the doctors, they started to think that, oh, well, it's all in her head. There's nothing really wrong with her. But yet the symptoms that I was experiencing were very real. The physical impact on my body was real. It was real to the point where I could not do much. It was real to the point where I had to leave the country. When it got cold, I had to leave the country. Everyone that I knew, everything that I was comfortable with, my life, I felt like I was in isolation, because while I was in Jamaica, I did not grow up there for most of my time. I did not have a lot of family or friends there. And the experience for me was a bit traumatic, to put it lightly, or extremely traumatic, to put it lightly. But I didn't know what was going on. I didn't have doctors that knew what was going on. Eventually I end up going to Wildwood, which they found out that I had traces of something with autoimmune based on the test that they did. Couldn't figure out what it was. They also found out that my sinuses, which were extremely bad, which I had surgery on in just 2 years prior. So this was very troubling. They told me that I needed to get follow-up care when I went back to New York, whereas I was living at the time. When I went back to New York, I continued seeing multiple doctors. I went to an ENT surgeon who was not my original surgeon, but he did some tests, allergy tests, everything, and scheduled the surgery. And then in the follow-up visit right before the surgery, he told me that he was not going to conduct the surgery because I was hesitating, which for me was like a shattering, and I couldn't understand it, because I had been looking forward to the surgery, expecting that I would be better after the surgery from all that I had been experiencing. So it didn't make sense to me that he thought that I was hesitating, because, you know, I was pushing, you know, let's get this done as soon as possible. It made a little bit more sense to me that God had stopped that when I went to see another surgeon. This was a surgeon, a colleague of my initial surgeon. And when he looked at my records and saw all that was done on my behalf, what was done during the surgery, he came back and he told me, I can't do surgery on you, because if I did surgery on you, I would do more harm than good. And you would not be well. You would probably be back here about every 2 years for a surgery. So yeah, it's not in your best interest for me to do the surgery. I was shocked, but I, you know, kept going. I tried everything that I could. I kept doing what I learned at Wildwood. And I went through continuously going to see more doctors. all kinds of doctors getting tests done. They would find little traces of stuff here and there. They would find little abnormalities, but nothing to help them resolve the issue or even pinpoint what my issue was. Nothing helped. Eventually, I kept going back and forth to doctors until I went to another lifestyle center, Beacon of Hope. And once I went to Beacon of Hope, we went through another detoxing, another series of natural remedies, so to speak, or lifestyle changes to try to help me get better. I think it was after this experience at Beacon of Hope, you know, I'd been gradually getting better since I went to Wildwood, but I still had symptoms. But after my experience at Beacon of Hope, you know, I lost a lot more of the symptoms. I was able to function more in society. And this was over a 2-year period. I still had issues. I still have high inflammation rate. I would still have little bouts of things happening, but I would not react in the same way that I reacted before. And so, you know, I praise God because even though my mystery illness has never been diagnosed, nobody's ever figured out the cure for it. Through a lifestyle change, God has brought me to a point where I can now function in society again. Yes, there's little things that happen to me here and there, little allergies that I never had before that is not picked up on tests that happens to me from time to time. But since then, I have been able to function to a point where now I am recording this video from Michigan, which, as you may imagine, is a very cold place, but I am able to function. And so today I am thankful and I give God all the glory for his resolution of my mystery illness.
Life, health, and strength for my family, friends, and intimates in this beautiful Sabbath morning.
I'm thankful for the love of God. And I say that because he loved me so much that he didn't just die. He was crucified. He was mocked. He was spat on. And he wore a crown of thorns on his head and the blood just came trickling down. And if that wasn't enough, a soldier came by riding, had a spear, and pierced him inside. And before he gave up the ghost, he said to his father, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do." How can I not love a savior like that?
I'm thankful for my home, my family, and my health.
I'm thankful for my dogs. They make me smile every day.
Hi, I'm thankful for my life, my family, and my friends.
Hi, my name is Ruth Austin. Thanksgiving is a time of togetherness and gratitude. It's a time to reflect on things that matter most in life. I'm thankful this Thanksgiving for health, family, friends, everyone around the world, mostly for taking nothing for granted and every breath as a gift from God. Thanks and happy Thanksgiving to everyone.
Hi, my name is Alexa France. I am Michelle and Oliver France's daughter. I am thankful for my family and I am thankful that they're still alive and well.
I am thankful to be alive. I'm thankful to be in this season, even though it's been a very challenging year. Thankful that God has protected me throughout this year and has provided so much for me. I'm thankful that I can see what's happening right now. And it's a wake-up call to let us all know that Jesus Christ is coming soon and that things on this planet are wrapping up. So we shouldn't be fearful about that. It should bring us hope and encouragement. So I'm thankful that everyone is pretty much doing okay in my family. I'm thankful for protection, and I look forward to what lies ahead.
Greetings, dear Yvonne and brothers and sisters in Christ. In 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 18, it reads, "In everything give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you." Well, there is no blessing, no trial, no time in which it is not appropriate to give thanks to the Lord. In fact, this verse commands us to thank the Lord for everything. Having made this the rule of my life, along with Romans 8:28, on September 1st, 2017, when my husband, the late Rick Shorter, passed, I was severely challenged by these verses. However, by faith, I claimed them, knowing that all things work together for good to them that love God and to them who are the called according to his purpose, Romans 8:28. We have set aside this day, Thanksgiving Day, to give thanks and to praise the Lord for all of his blessings, and this is good. But let us consider that in him we live and move and have our being. And every good and perfect gift comes down from the Father of lights, in whom there is no variableness, neither shadow of turning. My list is very long that I thank and praise him for every day. I will sing and speak of the mercies of the Lord forever. With my mouth will I make known thy faithfulness every day, in everything and always. I will lift up mine eyes unto the hills, from whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. Let us praise and thank the Lord in everything and every day, for he is worthy to be praised. I have a grateful heart. I pray that you have a grateful heart as well, every single day of your life. Sister Gwen Shorter and family, Crystal, Promise, Hope, and Christian. God bless you all. Happy Thanksgiving.
Hi, my name is Aurel France. I'm Michelle and Oliver France's son, and this Thanksgiving, I'm thankful that all of my immediate family's members and I are all in good health.
This is what I am thankful for. I am Diane Banjo. I live in Atlanta, Georgia. Father God, I just thank you for the breath of life, O Lord. I thank you, Father, for the heart of Thanksgiving, Father. And I give you all the praises, Father, for all the experiences that I encounter in my life. Teach me, O Lord, to be joyful always, Father, to pray continuously and give thanks to all my circumstances. I accept them as your will for my life, O Lord. And Father God, I just thank you for my entire family, O Father. I'm thankful for my husband, our children, our grandchildren, our sisters, our brothers, our nieces, our nephews, O Father, all of our cousins and our uncles and our aunties and our sister-in-laws and brother-in-laws that are so far away in Africa, O Lord. Father, I thank you for the bloodline that you've given to this family, O Father. And Father, I defeat him through my sacrifice of praise, Father. And Father, I just thank you, Father, for being the God that you are, O Father. I give thanksgiving, Father, for this holiday season that we're in the midst of, O Lord. I thank you for keeping me and my family, O Father, safe, O Father, during this COVID-19 period, O Father. There are so many, O Lord, that did not make it, O Father. And Father, I just worship you and praise your holy name as you have placed all your blessings around my family. around everyone that I know, my friends, my church family, our pastor, oh Father, Pastor Marvin C. Jones, oh Father, and First Lady Tavis Jones, oh Father, and all of the saints of Central Baptist Church, oh Lord. Father God, I just thank you and I honor you. I bless your holy name, oh Father. This is a time of prayer and supplication for all of us, Father. Father, I come asking you just to heal our land, oh Father. Continue to give us peace, oh Father, that surpasses all understanding, Father. Especially those, Father, who have lost loved ones, oh Father, during this COVID-19 pandemic, oh Lord. Continue to just bless their families, oh Father. Continue to let them know that all praises go to you, oh Father. And without you, oh Father, we are nothing. I thank you, oh Lord. I honor you. It is in your precious Son, Jesus' holy name, I do pray. Amen, amen, amen.
So many times I needed you. So many times that you came through. So many times I had to call. You came to my rescue. So many times I had to pray. So many times you made a way. So many times I had to cry, and you came to my rescue.
And together we say thank you.
At times the load is heavy, at times the road is long, and circumstances come your way, and you think you can't go on. When you're feeling at your weakest, Jesus will be strong. He'll provide the answer. When you found all hope is gone, he'll find a way. For I know that if he can paint a sunset and put the stars in place, I know if he can raise up mountains and calm the storm-tossed waves, and if he can conquer death forever to open heaven's gates, then I know for you, I know for you, he'll find a way. Oh, yes, he will. Do you believe that? And at times your heart is breaking with a pain that's so intense, and all you hold are broken pieces to a life that makes no sense. He wants to lift you up and hold you and mend each torn event. He'll pick up the pieces that you thought had all been spent. God is gonna find a way. Oh, yes, he will. For I know that if he can paint a sunset and put the stars in place, I know if he can raise up mountains and calm the storm-tossed waves, and if he can conquer death forever to open heaven's gates, then I know for you, I know for you. For I know that if he can paint a sunset and put the stars in place, I know if he can raise up mountains and calm the storm-tossed waves, and if he can conquer death forever to open heaven's gates, then I know for you, God is more than able to see you through. He'll will find a way. Oh, yes, he will. He'll find a way. And if he can conquer death forever to open heaven's gates, then I know for you, God is more than able to see it through. He'll find a way. Oh, yes, he will. He'll find a way.
Pastor Dr. Lawrence Brown is a native New Yorker. In the past 30 years, he ministered in the Northeastern Conference of Seventh-day Adventists, serving many congregations, and served as director for several conference departments. For example, the Publishing, Religious Liberty, Sabbath School, Stewardship, and Trust Services. Pastor Dr. Lawrence Brown has been married for over 27 years. He and his wife, Sherry, have one adult daughter. His favorite Bible promise is, "But we have this treasure in earthen vessels that have the excellency of the power may be of God and not of us." 2 Corinthians 4:7. Hear ye him.
Beloved, let us pray. Father in heaven, we thank you for your word and its power to impact our hearts and lives. As we consider it briefly together today, move in all of us, I pray. Shape us, strengthen us, empower us, and keep your promise, because you said we have this treasure in earthen vessels, that the excellency of the power may be of God and not of us. I, the earthen vessel, am here. Let the excellency of the power be here as well. In Jesus' name, amen. This time of year, thankfulness is on everybody's heart, on everybody's mind. Everybody's talking about it. I want to speak to you on the topic, though, of the right kind of thankful. The right kind of thankful. Now, somebody said, "Preacher, what are you talking about, the right kind of thankful? I thought thankful was thankful." But as we open the Word of God, we begin to discover, we begin to understand that there's thankful, and then there's thankful. Over in Luke chapter 20 and verse 1, the Bible declares, "After these things, the Lord appointed other 70 also, and sent them two by two before his face into every city and place whither he himself would come." After commissioning the 70 and sending them out, we read down a few verses, and the Bible gives us this report. Something happened. They got excited. Something happened. Down in verse 17, the Bible declares, "And the 70 returned again with joy, saying, Lord, even the devils are subject unto us through thy name." These workers for the Lord, these ministers of the gospel, they came back high-fiving each other, clapping each other, excited, thankful that as they went out, they were able to perform miracles and do things, and they were happy about it. They were excited. They were joyful. They were thankful. And Jesus, after giving them a certain backdrop, giving them a certain background, in verse 20, he gives them this understanding and wants to let them know, yes, it's okay to be thankful about certain things, but I need you to kick it up a notch. Because over in verse 20, he declares, "Notwithstanding, in this rejoice not, that the spirits are subject unto you, but rather rejoice, because your names are written in heaven." Think about what God is saying here. He's saying to his workers, he's saying to his servants, he's saying to his sons and daughters, yes, yes, all that other stuff is okay. All that other stuff is good. You're happy that you got power. You're happy that you're able to do things in my name. But what I really want you to be thankful for, what I really want you to be excited about, what I really want you to be motivated about is the fact that your name is written up in glory. There are things down here that we are thankful for. They are transitory. They are trivial sometimes. They are short term. Their usefulness only goes but so far. And God says, rather than getting all invested up in all of that, I want you to be thankful for the things that really matter. We find this lesson being taught over and over and over again in Scripture. For example, in John chapter 5 and verse 2, it tells the story of the man laying there at the pool of Bethesda. The Bible says that a certain man had an infirmity 38 years. And so when Jesus shows up and takes pity on him, the man was thankful, but you know what he wanted to be thankful for? He wanted to be thankful that now there's finally somebody that can help drag me down to that nasty water and maybe, just maybe, it will heal me. The Bible says the impotent man answered him, "Sir, I have no man when the water is troubled to put me into the pool, but while I am coming, another steppeth down before me." So this brother was getting ready to be thankful that he could lean on Jesus and they could stand there watching, waiting for that water to bubble, waiting for that water to bubble, waiting for that water to bubble. And then he's going to lean on Jesus and they're going to knock over the man with the crutch and they're going to push back the woman who has whatever handicap or deformity. And before anybody else can beat them out, this man was ready to be thankful that Jesus was going to help him get to the water. But Jesus said, "No, no, no, baby. We're going to kick it up a notch. You looking at some filthy water? I got something better for you." He said, "It's time to kick it up." And he declared in verse 8, "Rise, take up thy bed and walk." He said, "You want to be thankful? Oh, I'm going to give you something to be thankful for." We find the same lesson taught in Acts chapter 3 and verse 2. The Bible declares, "And a certain man, lame from his mother's womb, was carried, whom they laid daily at the gate of the temple, which is called Beautiful, to ask alms of them that entered into the temple. Who, seeing Peter and John about to go into the temple, asked in alms." So this brother was thankful that the disciples walked in, but he was thankful because he thought, "Oh, they're going to break off a little money for this brother." He was thankful because he thought, "Here's somebody else coming to hook a brother up, help a brother out." And the disciples said, "No, no, no, baby, it's not that kind of party. Oh, you're going to be thankful, but you're going to be thankful for a better reason, thankful for a higher reason." The disciples said, "Silver and gold have I none." And when they said that, I'm sure he said to himself, "Oh, here come another broke brother with another broke sob story. Can't help me out." But before he could get all up and down with his pity party, the disciples declared, "Listen, we don't have money. And I know you were thankful when you saw us walk in because you thought we would give you some money." He said, "But such as I have, give I thee." And I'm not about to drop some money on you. I'm about to drop a blessing on you. He said, "In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk." He said, "Oh, I'm going to give you a higher thankful. I'm going to give you a better thankful. I'm going to show you that where you were prepared to be thankful with just trivial things, thankful for just transitory things, he said, I'm going to drop a blessing on you that will really make you thankful." In the book Fundamentals of Christian Education, the servant of the Lord declares, "When we aim at a low standard, we shall reach only a low standard." In other words, we're walking around here thankful, but some of us are walking around here thankful for the wrong kind of thing. Thankful that we made it to the next level in our favorite video game. Thankful that our favorite weekly TV show had a happy ending or a good storyline. Thankful that the hero ended up with the girl in the movie. Thankful that our favorite team won. Thankful that the store is not out of our favorite flavor of ice cream. thankful that Biden won. See, all of these are things that you could be thankful for, and the Bible says be thankful in everything, but God wants us to kick it up a notch. He says in Matthew chapter 6, this is the lesson he's trying to teach us. He says, therefore, take no thought saying, what shall we eat? Because some of us, we're thankful for food, amen. Or what shall we drink? Oh yeah, we get thirsty, amen. Or wherewithal shall we be clothed? Or we're thankful for the clothes on our back, amen. He said, for after all these things do the Gentiles seek. Jesus said, you walking around with that kind of thankful, you're not doing better than the person that doesn't believe in me. Everybody's worried about that. And then he says this. He says, for your heavenly Father knoweth that you have need of all these things. He said, you walking around here like it's some surprising thing that you got it. No. God knows you need it, and God is prepared to take care of you. He says, but let me help you kick it up a notch. He says, but seek ye first the kingdom of God. That's what's up. He says, be thankful that you have a mind to seek God. He said, be thankful that I put it on your heart to want a place in my kingdom. He said, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. That is the right kind of thankful. The Bible is trying to help us understand that we need to be thankful, but thankful for Jesus. The word declares, for God didn't just love the world, but for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever should believe it. Isn't that wonderful? No matter where you're from, no matter whether you've got letters behind your name or not, no matter whether you like rice and peas or peas and rice, the Bible said, whoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Now, that's something to be thankful for. Thankful. You want to be thankful? Be thankful for his sacrifice. Romans chapter 5 and verse 8 declares, but God commendeth his love toward us in that while we were yet sinners, yet wicked, yet unrighteous, yet gamblers, yet gossipers, yet womanizers, yet full of foolishness, yet full of stuff, while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. And his sacrifice makes the difference. His sacrifice opens the way. You want to be thankful? You want to be thankful? Be thankful for his promise. He declares in John chapter 14 and verse 1, let not your heart be troubled. Think about it. Let not your heart be troubled. Jesus is saying, it doesn't matter who the president is. Let not your heart be troubled. It doesn't matter who controls the Senate. Let not your heart be troubled. It doesn't matter who won The Voice. It doesn't matter who won Dancing with the Stars. It doesn't matter who won America's Got Talent. It doesn't matter who won Ninja Warrior. It doesn't matter who won the Super Bowl. Jesus says, let not your heart be troubled. Why? Ye believe in God, believe also in me. You want to be thankful? Be thankful that in my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. You want to be thankful? Be thankful that I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. Now that's something to be thankful for. That's something that no one can take from you. That's something that when you have it, you have it. You want to be thankful? Be thankful for his abiding presence. The Bible declares, let your conversation be without covetousness, and be content with such things as ye have. Why? The Bible says, for he hath said, I will never leave thee nor forsake thee. Now that's something to be thankful for. We running around here talking the money is funny and the change is strange. But God is saying, when you have me, you have everything that you need in this life. So you want to be thankful? Be thankful that he says, I'll never leave you. Be thankful that he says, I'll never forsake you, for never forsake you. Be thankful that when you have nothing else, your greatest resource is the fact that you know God and that God knows you. You want to be thankful? You want to be thankful? Be thankful for his grace. Be thankful for his mercy. Be thankful that one day we will crown him King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Be thankful for his declaration in Isaiah chapter 43, verse 6. What did he say? Oh, he gave us something to be thankful for. He said, I will say to the north, give up, and to the south, keep not back. Bring my sons from far and my daughters from the ends of the earth. Be thankful that everyone that is called by my name, for I have created him for my glory. I have formed him. Yea, I have made him. That's something to be thankful for. God has announced the fact that one day situation and circumstance will not be able to hold back when he comes to receive us unto himself. It doesn't matter what you've gone through down here. We can be thankful that God is going to show up and nobody can stop him. Nobody can block him. Nobody can hold him back. It doesn't matter what has happened. It doesn't matter what has transpired. It doesn't matter what we have gone through. His promise is you can be thankful because I sit high and I look low. He said in Isaiah chapter 51, verse 11, therefore, hear the verse, claim the verse, put it in your pocket and walk around with it. Therefore, the redeemed of the Lord shall, and I like that word shall means it's going to happen. That word shall means nobody can stop it. That word shall means nobody can get in its way. Nobody can hold it down, knock it down, lock it down. Therefore, the redeemed of the Lord shall return and come with singing into Zion, and everlasting joy shall be upon their head. They shall obtain gladness and joy, and sorrow and mourning shall flee away. That's the promise of God. That's a reason to be thankful. That's a reason to shout. That's a reason to know that God has us covered. And so, like the songwriter, we can all declare, though the storms keep on raging in my life, and sometimes it's hard to tell the night from day, still that hope that lies within is reassured as I keep my eyes upon the distant shore. I know he'll lead me safely to that blessed place he has prepared. So we are thankful. Why? Because if the storms don't cease, and if the winds keep blowing in my life, I'm thankful that my soul has been anchored in the Lord. And pandemic can't separate me. Politics can't separate me. Trouble and trauma can't separate me. We are thankful. Thankful that even though the billows may roll and the breakers may dash, I shall not sway because he holds me fast. Thankful, so dark the day, clouds in the sky. I know it's all right. Why? Because Jesus is nigh, and that's why I'm thankful. Thankful for his presence. Thankful for his love. Thankful for his mercy. Thankful because God keeps me. Thankful because God loves me. Thankful because he's coming back for me. And there's not one thing this world can do to stop it. So let's be thankful, the right kind of thankful. Let's be thankful for a higher reason. Let's not settle with the low-hanging fruit. Let's not settle for just the trivial and the trifling things in this life. Let's be thankful because God is. Let's be thankful because he's working in our hearts and lives. Let's be thankful that by his grace we can be like him. Let's be thankful that he can break the power of sin. Let's be thankful that he can rescue us, save us from ourselves. Let's be thankful that every day we can grow more and more like him. Let's be thankful. Let's be thankful. Let's be thankful. And that, beloved, is the right kind of thankful. God bless you.
Dear Lord God, thank you for this season of grace that we are in. Thank you for every provision that you have provided for us, for we know that we have everything that we need in Christ Jesus. Thank you for the word of hope on today, the right kind of thankful. As we go through our day, may it resonate in our hearts and minister to each one of us. In Jesus' name, amen.
I am so glad that my Father in heaven tells of his love in the book he has written. Wonderful words in the Bible I see. This is the dearest that Jesus loves me. I am so glad that Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. Oh, I am so glad that Jesus loves me. Jesus loves even me. God sees a little sparrow falls. It meets his tender view. If God so loves the little things, I know he loves me too. He loves me too. He loves me too. I know he loves me too. If God so loves the little things, I know he loves me too. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me, for the Bible tells me so. And if God can love all the little things, I know he loves me too. I know he loves me too. I am so glad that my Father in heaven tells of his love in the book he has written. Wonderful words in the Bible I see. This is the dearest that Jesus loves me. I am so glad that Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. Oh, I am so glad that Jesus loves me. Jesus loves even me. God sees a little sparrow falls. It meets his tender view. If God so loves the little things, I know he loves me too. He loves me too. He loves me too. I know he loves me too. If God so loves the little things, I know he loves me too. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me, for the Bible tells me so. And if God can love all the little things, I know he loves me too. I know he loves me too. Me too. I am so glad that my Father in heaven tells of his love in the book he has written. Wonderful words in the Bible I see. This is the